Hey guys, Nick with Aabbott Ferraro here. I'm over in Minneapolis, Nokomis neighborhood, and we're at Adam and Nikki's house, real good customers of ours. And I got a couple different systems to show you today. And I think the Fujitsu's running, yep. So this is a 15 below Fujitsu heat pump. And if you follow the lines up, that's going up into their half-story bedroom. It's kind of a office master bedroom suite. And what they had before was they had electric baseboard heat with an old Samsung mini split air conditioner. So when it came time to replace the Samsung, it stopped working. We actually took that out and put in a heat pump, the Fujitsu 15 below. And so now they're heating and cooling that half-story. They don't have to use their electric baseboard heat anymore. And yeah, this unit is keeping this whole area heated all winter long. They run the fan on auto, and then when it gets really, really cold, they bump the fan speed up a little bit to push more air down here. And then Nikki said they're running the ceiling fan too, just to circulate air around. But it's pretty impressive. They had, I think, three. Oh, in fact, here's an old baseboard heater they're not using anymore. They had left one here just in case, but that's the baseboard heat that they had before, and that's what they're heating with. And we'll talk to Adam about it later, but he figures their electric bill dropped about half when they put in the heat pump versus the electric heat. So they're saving quite a bit.
We couldn't be happier with it. Honestly, what we had up there before was baseboard electric heat, and it was incredibly expensive to run, and it was really hard to regulate how hot or cold it was at any given time. And now we just have a thermostat, and we set it and we forget it, and it just always maintains really nicely.
And in the summer we had a mini split that that cooled but was expensive to run, was very inefficient, also did not have as good as control from a placement point of view, where the heater is now placed.
The temperature was really hard to maintain.
The temperature was really hard to maintain, both hot and cold, but now where it is and designed to fit that space, it works incredibly well. That room is very comfortable year round.
Even in the back corners.
And the nice thing about the Fujitsu is that in the fall and the spring, it'll switch over back and forth on its own. So during those hot days in the fall, it'll air condition during the middle of the day, but at night, if it gets cool enough, it'll actually just kick on the heat.
Now you guys left, I think we had one heater that we left up there just in case. Have you guys ever had
it's actually not even hooked up.
Didn't even hook it up? Okay.
No, there's no electricity.
I know we're a little hesitant, and we're thinking maybe we might need it at 20 below.
I know it's supposed to not work so well at 20 below, but even this winter when we finally got cold enough that week before Christmas, we never needed supplemental heat. And our electric bill last winter dropped by at least 40% for most of the winter. Mm-hmm. And we were keeping it warm consistently because we had a new baby.
Okay.
So, you know, we were heating more and more consistently, and we were paying about 40 when I calculated it.
40% less.
40%
and
less.
And then now we've taken out the baseboards everywhere else, and it's gone down even more.
Yeah.
So. We'd set it and forget it, and it's done. I never thought we'd get that in an 80-year-old house.
Nice. Well, we appreciate you guys' business over the years.
Yeah.
We've done a lot of work with you guys, and I appreciate you letting me come over and do the video.
Absolutely.
Anytime.
All right. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.